Hello there, and welcome back to the LOSUMG podcast. Today, it's Stokbassi hosting, and I'm joined by No Snow, Titmuff, and Jupiter. Hello, guys.
Hello.
How are you?
Hungry.
Yeah.
No. Alright, so everyone's hungry except for me because I just ate. Titmuff is meh, which is normal for Titmuff. And I got beer, so I'm fine. Just let's start with the LOSUMG news. Not too much. We got a modded Minecraft server up and running. As you probably will know, the 4th of April, guided by No Snow, we launched the official modded Minecraft server for LOSUMG for the year 2016. We are running it on Minecraft versions 1.7 and with the mod pack Feed the Beast Infinity 2.4.2, something like that. No Snow, is that correct?
Feed the Beast Infinity 2.4.2, yeah. I believe, yeah.
Yeah. So, how have you enjoyed it already? Well, of course everybody did, but what have you all been doing?
Well, I'll go first then.
Yeah.
I've been working with you, haven't I, Doc? We've been generating some power for our utility company. With that, you know, we've already developed into like the second stage of it, and moving forward and providing power for everyone is our next goal. We won't give him any power, being so rude, but the aim for us is to provide power for everybody in the Minecraft world.
Yep. Well, to update you, it won't be on the recording because it was just, well, it wasn't my work, it was Neshka and it was invisible. But in the ME system, we can now make automatically advanced solar panels.
Ooh.
The only thing that we have to do is make sure that the resources are in there, and the only two things that we can't make are the star things. How are they called again?
Perhaps we should put a spoiler alert up.
No, because it won't be in the recordings, in the episodes.
Okay.
The only thing, we can't, there's a certain type of star that we can't craft yet, so we have to put that one in the system. And the same goes for iridium ore. We can make the, we can process the ore, but we can't process the shards.
Okay, jobs yeah. to do.
No, I don't think that's a good thing to do, because if you input more than 9, if you input a number that can't be divided by 9, you're going to have it stuck in the compressor. So that's not a good thing. Timoth, what have you been doing?
Well, not a lot, because Meepo is like online at awkward times of the day, and I sort of don't really care very much.
Yeah, well, besides that, what have you guys been doing?
We built a circle out of stone in the wall.
Yeah, sure, okay.
Pretty much it, really.
Yeah. And you been here?
I haven't had a lot of time lately to actually get on, but I'm part of the farming community, but with the lack of time on, I'm a little bit behind, but I'm starting to build up the infrastructure of my block that I've designated for myself.
Cool.
The thing is that with you farm guys, spring is more than made up for your absence, though.
Hmm. Oh, yeah, true. Only because he's got so much time on his hands.
Yeah, the amount of what Springy's been doing is just amazing. I'd say go check him out, go watch his videos, and you'll see the progress that he made compared to the other guys. It's only just now that a few bit more tall buildings have been started, so the difference is getting it's getting more equal now, but still you can see he's a huge step forward.
Okay, so tune into that series, and you can find out what everybody's been doing, I guess.
Yeah, because basically almost everybody's been doing videos, so just check one of the LOSUMG guys, and you'll see the links to all the channels for everybody, and you'll see everybody's videos. Right, so well, with that, that was the only LOSUMG news that was worth noting. We had two events in the last month, which were the Open TTD Championship and the Modded Minecraft starting stream, which we already talked about. The Open TTD Championship had been won by Cooldude, which was, I must still say, quite surprising. Well done to him.
I think he did very well. He went for oil at the beginning, didn't he?
He started off with passengers and oil. So, well, yeah, he had a very good start. Well, the start is the most important part of any Open TTD championship or race or contest, whatever. Because if you can make good progress in the start, if you use your money efficiently, it's much easier to get more money quicker, and basically to win, of course.
Well, I guess round of applause to Cooldude then.
Yeah, definitely. And it will be the last Open TTD Championship that I will host, because I also learned that I'm a shit host for that. I'm not going to beat that one out, by the way. Right, so events to come. The Geddes Mod Air Racer, which is going to be hosted by Master Hellish. It is currently scheduled for the 16th of July. So, well, Hellish isn't here, so you can't tell any more about that, which is a shame.
I think we'll be doing a bit of recording for another upcoming season of some Minecraft UHC on that day as well, so
yeah,
be a busy day for all the LOSUMG guys.
Yeah, definitely. By the way, regarding UHC number 4, keep an eye on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, whatever is regarding LOSUMG, because there might be some interesting updates on that. Quickly, let's continue to the member news. Next to the fact that almost everybody started the Modded Minecraft series, I also started my Hitman Blood Money series, which I talked about last week, and I ended Open TTD series 2. However, that's not going to be the last Open TTD on my channel. It will be back in the future in a bit different shape, but I'm not going to tell anything about that. Yay!
So, gonna keep people guessing.
Yeah, I'm gonna keep people guessing. It won't be a Let's Play series, that's all I'm gonna say. Alright, so any news from you guys regarding your channels?
Not that I can think of. Maybe videos will come out when they're supposed to go out on my channel?
Well, that would be great news.
Well, not promising anything, but you know.
Yeah.
It might happen.
Yeah. You know,
Maybe.
I really like your videos, so it would be cool to know when they are actually going to be online. How about
you? I just don't stick to it because I'm disorganized.
Yeah. Oh well. You'll be fine.
Mm.
You'll be fine. You know, there's such a thing that you can use your telephone, which is called an agenda. Right?
An agenda?
Yeah, an agenda. You can write down stuff, which is quite weird. I mean, that's normally you wouldn't do such a thing. You can write down stuff, tie that to a specific date and time. Not only a date, but also a time. And it will give you a notification on a specific time that you have to do something or that you have to be somewhere.
Oh, you mean like a reminder or a calendar?
Yeah, something like that, yeah. But then on your telephone.
Yeah, that could work.
You never know, he says.
I mean, it doesn't help though if it like says you need to upload this video now. Oh, You mean that one I haven't edited yet? Okay, sure.
Well, that's why you can add the events, like, got to record it then, got to edit it before then, and then just, well, for example, let's say, oh, it has to go online tomorrow, let's edit it. Something like that.
Yeah, mostly I realize I need to edit something when it needed to have gone out.
I know the problem, don't worry.
Time
well, like the day after, I'm like, oh, it was Wednesday yesterday, I was supposed to put Worms out, oh well.
Still got to render it. How about you, your career? Anything new?
Well, it's been out nearly a month now, but I've started a new Banished series. That started off quite well so far.
How's it going?
It's going all right. I'm doing a new little thing with it. I'm actually keeping track of the actual family trees of the original starting families of the banished group that you start with.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm basically keeping record of that. That's a new little thing I'm trying to do with it. But I mean, if it's not successful this time round, I'm going to be doing a modded version of Banished.
All right, but how would you mod Banished? What different things can you see then?
There's one mod that basically gives you an entirety of different of building types, mm-hmm. so that it expands it out. Like, there's only a very limited amount of types of buildings you can have, so they've introduced loads of different kind of manufacturing buildings, and to the customization is like times by 10. You know, there's so much more you can do in the villain of the game with the mod, and it just encourages you to be more sensible and to be more concentrating on making sure everything's working properly, since there's so much more involved in the game. But as I haven't had a lot of practice on the modded program just yet, I'm keeping it just vanilla at the moment.
Yeah, I can imagine. To be very honest, I find the vanilla way too hard for myself as well, because I tend to go for the hard start, because, well,
yeah,
if you look at the start, the easy and the medium one are basically too easy. And then you start with the heart, and well, it's all fine, but quite forget.
At the end of the day, the difficulty doesn't actually change the game itself. It only changes the difficulty of your starting scenario.
Really? I thought it also.
No, it doesn't make the game any harder. It just makes that you're not in a. You basically start with bare nothing on hard.
Oh, and, right.
But then the easier difficulties, you've got all the food ready already for you and everything like that, when you've actually got to make sure food is a priority before even the first winter hits.
I really thought that on the hard difficulty you would also have more chance of getting
disasters.
Yeah, getting disasters.
They're exactly the same.
Alright.
So you can get a tornado ripping right through your town on easy, like really early in the game, if it spawns it. And yeah, I think there's a certain, like, you have to get to a certain point in the game before physical disasters actually start happening. I don't think you can get it like straight off the bat.
Yeah.
You need to progress a little bit into the game, so it lets you progress in, and then the disasters will, you know, the cycling of see if it activates or not gets activated. And that's how I seem think it works, because I never really had a disaster really early in the game.
Yeah, it wouldn't be fair really as well, to be honest.
No, but no, the general difficulty is not changed whatsoever. It's just the physical starting scenario. So,
can you not do an open TTD and turn them off completely?
Yes, you can. You can turn off disasters. Yes.
Hooray!
But end of the day, most people that fail Banished usually fail because they basically starve out their entire populace.
Yeah.
Because you don't concentrate. The food is the biggest thing that can basically kill off your town. if you haven't got that sorted out properly, and if you have like an early winter or something like that, it can kill your crops. That's not a disaster, that's just natural generation of winter. If it ends up hitting early, you could lose a quarter of your the last quarter of your crops before they've actually been harvested.
Oh, well, they were asking for it.
you would be a harsh
Yeah, you'd be a harsh town mayor, Tidmouth, you would be. You'd be like, suck it up, suck it up.
Tidmouth, do you know what game you have to play?
No.
Tropico.
Oh, Tropico.
You're gonna love Tropico. On one of my Steam accounts, I should have Tropico 4 and 5. I love the game.
I don't like 5 too much, I prefer 4.
Okay, I must say I prefer 5 to be honest. So basically because of the looks. And I also started playing at Tropico 5, so I never really played the earlier ones. I just love that you can not only build a city, but you can also rule it. And I think that's something that would be, for example, SimCity, or the other game. What's the other game called again?
City Skylines?
Yeah, City Skylines. They don't have that level of control over what's going to happen in your city. Well, at least I don't feel like that.
Well, Meeper does have Tropico 4, so I could play it. people aren't aware, Meeper's shared his Steam library with me, so I can basically just dip into his library and play whatever I want.
Which is amazing, yeah. You should give it a try, definitely, definitely. It's a good game. Yeah. Oh, well. Spoken about... not new games. We've had... how do I get from not new games to updates? Alright, never mind. That's the worst segue ever. Anyways, we had the new GTA 5 release. The release that cost me about... let's say 8 million in-game dollars until now, but which I really enjoyed. And I can't remember the name either. It was the something and felonies, I can't remember.
Felony and finance updates.
Felony and finance updates. Basically, they allow you to find your own company, make money with it, and just do some nice stuff. They also... added some very, very nice new vehicles. Including a tugboat, which I now can't buy because I spent all my money, which I was saving for a yacht, on a company in the Maze Bank Tower. And then I basically kept spending everything in upgrading vehicles and stuff like that. Basically what the main flow of the game is, the CEO, which is me in this case, hires other players, for example, No Snow Tidmouth, you better, which all happen to have GTA as well, which is quite odd. Huh? You go off do either some missions or you go off getting some crates. In that case, I have to buy crates, have to get them myself with the group, put them into a warehouse, and when I got a big amount of crates, I'll sell them for a much bigger value, which basically gives a lot of money and also costs quite some money. So, especially Tidmouth, you've been we've been playing the game quite a lot. What do you think of the update?
I quite like it. I feel like sort of some of the stuff you have to do in public sessions is a little bit annoying because I'm someone who really doesn't like public sessions in GTA at all. But I think when we were playing the other day, I think we did quite well.
Yeah.
We didn't get like too many annoying people.
Yeah, indeed. We were playing with the two of us, started on a server which had only 3 other players at the time. The only downside was we ended up having 24 other players. But even then, as Tim said, we didn't have hackers, we didn't have very irritating people. We only had one guy coming after us with a chat, if I'm correct.
Yeah, we had the one guy chasing us with a helicopter as well, but we ended up just shooting him at the sky.
Yeah, well, that was on another occasion. The chat was when we were still collecting the packages. And then we had to sell them, bring them out to sea with a tugboat. And someone with a helicopter tried to, I don't know, I think he tried to scratch the paint of the boat, something like that.
Yeah.
Well, I can't really remember. It was quite useless, and he ended parking his helicopter partially on the boat, partially at the bottom of the sea. And he himself ended up somewhere along the coast because he got slightly hurt during me shooting at him.
If people are interested in the actual things that have been added into the game besides like the offices and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
We have 12 new vehicles: the Grotti Bestia GTS, the Brigade, which is like a big armored truck, a variant of the Cargo Bob, a convertible version of the Windsor, which is like a Rolls Royce or some sort of thing, the Vafid FMJ, the Buckingham Nimbus, the Pegasi Reaper, the Bravado Rumpo Custom, the tugboat, the Buckingham Volatus,
Which is two versions
of the Benefactor XLS.
Yeah, very, very nice car, especially the van that you called out, the something custom.
The Brigade?
No, not the Brigade, the van.
Bravado Rumpo. Yeah.
Yeah, the Bravado Rumpo, which is, take in mind something like the A-Team van, which is just highly customizable. I didn't buy it yet because I want the Brigade first and I want to upgrade all the...
I've got the normal Rumpo, which is my LOSUMG van. It kind of looks like the van has been crossed with that that sort of little 4x4, the Mesa.
Oh yeah,
used
indeed.
By Meriwether.
Oh damn, you're right. I didn't think about it. Look, it got off-road tires, it got spare tires, I think it even got fuel tanks and stuff on the roof. Some kind of roof rack. I still got to buy all those vehicles. The first thing that Titmouth bought was a tug. Well, he was saving...
Of course.
Sorry?
Of course. The moment I saw the tugboat in the trailer, I was like, oh, tugboat, tugboat, tugboat. It was weird. It was such a weird coincidence as well, because like a few days before the update had come out and before I'd seen the trailer, I was just like wandering around the docks and I was like, there's a tugboat in the water here, why can't you drive it? And then this update came out and you could, and I was like, what?
Yeah, it was so amazing. It's terribly, terribly slow, but it's just, it's amazing. It's just amazing to have.
One thing I didn't realise, the drum magazine, which I added to my special carbine, that's actually new in this update as well.
Yeah, that's indeed true. But the only reason, because I'm not using them, the only reason is because they reload slower.
Yeah.
And I'm using the...
Carries 100 rounds, so you can still shoot for quite a long time.
Yeah, true, but on the other hand, the extended magazine carries 60 rounds. So that was basically my reason for not getting the drum magazine, but I can definitely imagine you want it, because the special carbine is, the best rifle, and it's nothing... There's nothing better than to be able to shoot more with your favorite weapon.
I do quite like the special carbine. I think sort of against when we, the three of me, you and Ubira were playing earlier, when we were having a standoff on top of the maze bank, I felt like the combat MG, was it I was using? I can't remember now.
Yeah, probably.
I felt like that was slightly better for taking out the armored policeman.
Yeah, probably because you got... I think they have better hitting power. However, they are less accurate. I prefer the special carbine myself because it's the most accurate assault rifle. And next to that, of course, the heavy... Is the heavy sniper or the heavy rifle? I can't remember.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's basically it's the 50 caliber sniper, and it rapes everything. It goes through. So I like it. Yay! I think it can even take down the tanker trucks with one shot. I think it can.
Maybe.
Yeah, I guess it did. We probably even have it on video somewhere, but I can't remember where and when. All right, so
you mean similar to the, is it like the Python handgun that you can get?
Yeah.
The revolver.
Yeah.
Yeah, that could do it in one shot, can't it?
I think it could. I can't remember me shooting at those trailers and killing them with one shot, but I can't remember if it was with the revolver or the heavy sniper. Right, but
time to find out.
Yeah, I guess we'll try to find out after this, after the podcast. Maybe a nice thing, little update on the Loser Mastermind the Mastermind Challenge, which we, the four of us, are doing. I think Titmuth is the... No, wait, we all died, and the only one who didn't cause a death was Euperior.
Mm-hmm. So, does killing yourself count?
I didn't kill myself.
No, he didn't.
No, I did.
Oh, sorry.
How did you? Yeah.
He blew himself up with a rocket.
Yeah. No,
he really did kill himself. He jumped out in front of me.
No, that's cruel. I tried to mate two chats together, which didn't work out the way I planned. Something like that. Yeah. But let's skip all the fails, because that's going to be in a very nice video sometime if we ever get the heist done. Now, we'll definitely get it done. The only reason why we keep failing, why we failed each time, was just because...
Stupid, silly things.
Yeah, because of stupid, silly things. Like, alright, we got this in the bag, let's just do this. And then you do something you shouldn't be doing and you die.
Yeah, like trying to park a jet in the back of another jet.
Oh, that was so amazing. You've got to see that on video. It's still... I can't figure out how it exactly happened. But, well, it happened.
Oh, no, I have no idea at all how it happened.
No, what I mean is... let's spoil this one then. Basically, it was on the... where we have to steal the EMP, which is in a Hydra. You got part of the Hydra inside the hangar in Sandy Shores. So Titmuth was doing that, and I was pushing him with my own chat. And suddenly Titmuth exploded. Well, I know it's a stupid risk. I should never have done it. But the odd thing is, the Hydra never started. It never caught fire. It just exploded.
And it had already passed the checkpoint.
It just sort of gone dump as if it had made it, but then it exploded. So.
Yeah. Well, it was just my mistake. Anything else about GTA, about the update? Any more experiences, or opinions, stuff like that?
Nah, that sounds like that.
I thought so, yeah.
I like the free RP I get from hanging out with you.
Oh, that's definitely a thing indeed. The associates get RP for hanging out in the vicinity of the CEO, and also they get RP for driving around, driving the CEO. That's a weird thing.
You also get 5,000 like at certain intervals as well, don't you?
Yeah, indeed. It's quite weird. I don't drive as much as I did before, just because, well, I'm CEO now. I get in the back of a vehicle and I'm getting drive to someplace else.
I'd really like if I'd be able to like overtake you in RP again.
Well, good luck.
Because I was ahead of you for ages, but then just at one point you just went and you were suddenly like 20 ahead of me.
Yeah, I I started playing a lot more and just cruising around, doing missions, races on my own, doing my dailies. And even though it's not too not a long time that I'm playing each evening, it's still quite a lot. So that's how I get the RP.
It's that's not... where I differ. I don't generally play unless there's someone to play with.
Yeah, and I started asking Tim every time because I would ask him once or twice a day, do you want to play GTA maybe? I don't do that anymore. I think that can get quite irritating at some point.
Yeah, just a bit.
Just a little. See, he has experience with it. Don't know how or why, but you know. Well, let's continue on after GTA. As you know, well, for the series, I've been playing Hitman Blood Money. All I want to say, it's still better than Hitman 2016. Yeah, well, they release new content, but I mean, it's gonna have only 5 maps in total. Like, what the heck? I want to play different maps. I want to be able to customize my weapons. Blood Money. So yeah, I really, really enjoy recording that series, and the nice thing is I keep trying new things to find out. And even though I played every mission like, who knows, 10, 15 times maybe, I keep finding new stuff, which is quite interesting. Well, can you help this? Train Simulator.
Oh, whoopee. Well, I'm continuing to have sort of issues with sort of certain things in the game. I posted a tweet probably just over a week ago at the time of recording. I was just driving along, doing the mission, nothing wrong, when all of a sudden a message popped up to say, yeah, you failed the mission because 2 NPCs had a crash on the other side of the map. So, that was fun.
I can imagine, yeah. How long was the drive?
I'd been going for probably over half an hour at least.
Oh, damn.
I said I wanted to do like a video recording. I feel like it's best if I do it as a live stream, though. So I can really show off, like, live to people, sort of my reactions to things as they happen.
Oh, I'm definitely going to watch that.
I don't know when it would be. I need to set something up.
Don't worry, I'll be watching. I really, really like the game. The only thing I miss is just multiplayer. I'd love to have that in multiplayer.
Yeah, that would be fun.
That definitely would be fun.
It'd be like maybe challenges, shunting challenges or something like
that. Yeah, or like a race even.
Yeah, you never know.
Like, the two people get put on the same map and say go from point A to point B and have, like, the best stop or something.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
Or maybe go from opposite ends and have to, like, go to each end of the line in opposite directions.
Yeah.
Yeah, but...
first person to get back to where they started.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, stuff like that would be very interesting.
Trains by Uran, which is like fairly, it's a bit of a cheaper train simulator. It's one I've played in the past that had a multiplayer mode, as far as I remember.
Did it? All right.
I think so. Yeah.
I at least can remember playing it, but I also can remember it sucked even more than normal train simulator.
The graphics in trains is very, very dated.
Well, I can remember, it was with a very long steam engine with a coal train going down a hill. And the odd thing is, it was just a single track, but you had passing places. So I was on that single track, I was coming up to a split with, obviously had a signal for me. And one of the tracks was free, and on the other track, another train was waiting. I can remember standing in front of a signal that was switching from red to green every second.
Yeah, that happens quite a lot. It's a weird game. It seems to play a bit more like perhaps a model railway rather than a real one.
Yeah, indeed. You're definitely right. By accident, I was searching for updates on the... train simulator with the Unreal 4. Was the Unreal 4 engine?
Yeah, there was rumors, I believe, of it using the Unreal 4 engine because the current engine is pretty outdated.
Yeah, what I learned about it, I'm not sure about this, is that it will be, well, let's say a separate game, because the current train simulator is basically the same game every time. Just more content, probably some bug fixes, but that's it.
Mm.
But this one is going to be a whole different game. I can definitely see it, why they do it, because there are people that put a lot of money into the normal one, and you can't just recreate the same content for a completely new engine at one time. Apparently, Nosno wants to ask about your PS VR. Nosno?
No.
Oops. Just asking if Euperiod heard any more about his VR system.
My VR system is currently in not dispatch, but in process to be dispatched. So the dispatch date is the end of this month.
Is there any good games you've managed to spot or find that you?
I've been collecting a few, but I'm also quite interested to actually enable VR just on normal games, because you can with the virtual desktop, which will make your any gate. Well, it's not going to be like proper VR, but you'll have the ability to look around on your screen while it bends around your head, basically. So you can play traditional games. Kind of VR.
Surround
game, yeah. Basically surrounded by the screen, basically. So you can have a look around. It's going to be interesting. Yeah. There's a couple of games coming out with the VR goggles as well, which one of them was made by the people that made Eve, I think, if I'm correct, which is another space, like, flight simulator type game. So it's going to be interesting. It's still very early on for proper games to go out, but there's been mentionings of a couple of games. I can't remember. I think Doom's been mentioned to be VR enabled soon, and there's another one which I'm actually interested in. I can't remember what it's called. There's another game that's going to be VR enabled. GTA is VR enabled already.
That would be cool.
Obviously playing first person, and it moves your character's head in the game with your own head. So you still use the keyboard and things. You're not exactly fully mobile on it. It's the VR goggles I got is the Oculus, which is mainly a sit down version of the VR system, while the Hive is a more of a stand up version. Until Oculus catch up with their controllers, but they're still, you're still a seated experience instead of being. I haven't got enough room for a standing VR experience, unfortunately. If I did, I would have gone for the Hive.
Definitely. It sounds really good.
It's going to be a massive thing.
There was
loads at E3.
Yeah, no, that's where I saw the mention of the two games that are being VR enabled soon. I just can't remember what the other one was. I know the first one was Doom, the new Doom game coming out. And there's another one. I mean, it'd be great if, like, for example, like Skyrim or Oblivion or the Elder Scroll games generally, that coming out in VR, that'd be amazing.
Yeah. I'm sure a lot of games will move over to it. There's plenty coming out soon.
There's one actually that's a VR one which I'm interested in, called Fortress Craft, which is a mixture of Factorio and Minecraft.
Alright.
That's already VR enabled. That's pretty good. If you check it out, because it is actually quite a nice game actually. It's still not alpha, I think it's beta now. It's not a full release game yet, it's early access still. But it's a mixture of both Factorio and Minecraft, if you're both fans of them, which most of us are.
Yeah.
So, I will be hopefully the goggles will arrive before the LAN party. I'm hoping, because they're coming from America, obviously. I hope to be able to bring it with us, with me, to the LAN, LOSUMG LAN.
Oh, that's going to be cool.
I wonder how many, like, people are going to try and hack them so that, like, an image suddenly appears in your face or something scary.
Oh, or... most like, I've seen some of the scary games. I'm not into the scary games, but I might download a few of them for you guys, but I'm definitely not going to play them.
I've really seen people cry because
I've seen people physically cry because they're so scared.
Yeah, I know. I definitely know what you're talking about. It's very cool if it's implemented correctly. For example, I think the best, currently one of the best examples of properly implement VR is gonna be found in War Thunder, where you actually are sitting in a plane, being able to look around by moving your head. I think that's amazing. Mm. And it's kind of essential in such a game, so it's quite good. The only downside is War Thunder sucks. Well, the game doesn't really, more like the company that's behind the game, Gajin Entertainment. They've been doing some very odd and very bad things in the recent weeks.
On the side note of games that we've been playing...
Mm-hmm.
Me and Tidmouth have been having a little bash at Space Engineers.
Yeah.
We've recently just screwed up in the game, but...
there's a restart button for a reason.
Yeah, no, there's a restart button. We haven't got very... We're basically practicing and playing around at the moment, but I'm interested to... well, I've been told not to, but I would like to create a server for that. So that, because currently you play on someone else's computer, you're joining as a guest and not
an actual player. If you're holding anything on you when the player exits the game, you basically just lose everything you're holding.
Which is quite odd.
Oh, it's because you're not you're a guest invited into the host computer. You're not.
Yeah.
It's not server based. It's not running through. It's running.
It's not
on
like Minecraft, where it like saves like UUID files or anything.
Yeah, no, it's still in early access, so that might be a feature might be in a later stage, but currently not. But I would like to make a server for anyone that's interested in the LOSUMG community, and yeah, but that's a little while off anytime soon yet. So.
I would like to do a series at some point, but I want to get better at the game first.
Yeah, as I said, I want to do a series. We could do a series together. There we go, there's a series.
Yay, series.
Be another series with just me and your period that hasn't started yet.
Hey, we've got a load in the pipeline, but at the moment one of them can't start physically because there's already a modded Minecraft currently going on.
Yes. Spoilers.
Ooh, spoilers. Interested.
Ooh.
Mm. Mm. But we need a bit of help from No Snow first. So.
Uh-oh.
Hello.
Hello.
He is No Snow.
Going back to VR, is Farming Simulator got VR?
Let's have a look. It will say on there. Is it in the Steam folder ready for release? As in the new Farm Simulator.
Is there a new Farm Simulator?
Yeah, that's got it. Well, it was a perfect segue, Tidmouth. Well done. Really good.
Thank you.
Really good. At the end of the year, I can't remember the actual date, but Farming Simulator 2017 has been released for pre-order. The only downside is you can only pre-order it at the website at the moment, and I want it at Steam, so that sucks. But anyway, it will come to Steam. Yes.
Oh no, it's a different. It's called Professional Farmer 2017.
If I can give you one tip, don't buy anything that tries to simulate Farming Simulator, because most of them suck.
Why would you want to simulate a farming simulator?
Well, Farming Simulator has been relatively successful since the last releases. 2013 was successful. 2015 was even more successful. So it is it's a nice game, and people try to reproduce it in their own kind of way, but basically they tend to fail.
Well, that's basically anything that's popular. People will try to rip it off. I mean, look at the number of like Minecraft rip-off games there are like everywhere.
Yeah, definitely. Look at the new Battlefield. That's a rip-off.
Of Minecraft, what?
No. The new Battlefield. It's a rip-off from Verdun. Verdun comes with World War One team. First
game. Oh, yes, I've heard about this, yeah.
Yeah. The first time there's going to be a new Battlefield. How odd. It's in the World War One team. Do you think it was
successful? Yeah, right, they've finally gone back in time, which I prefer the World War ones instead of the modern.
World War 263.
Yeah. I prefer World War II still.
That is an interesting approach to go to a World War One. There wasn't that many that came out.
Yeah, true, but it's too bad. It's, well, basically, hey, someone has a good idea. Let's do it as well.
You know what I'd like to see? I'd like to see a train simulator, like, map or mission or whatever, set during World War Two.
When you're getting bombed.
I can see
having to work through the blackout and stuff, so you really can't see anything.
Blacked out trains
bombed around you.
Didn't can you imagine happening this? This happening, mission failed. A plane on the other side of the map has bombed the train.
Shot down by the Germans.
I'm sorry. The
NPC Spitfire 172 has been shot down.
Yeah, indeed.
You failed. What?
Yeah,
but I mean, I don't know about like in Britain, but I know in America at least there's like trains that have like missile launchers and guns and stuff on them.
I got to look at the German and the Russian trains. Some of those are just crazy.
Yeah, I think somebody linked me to like one of them on Facebook or something. It was like one of them next to Thomas the Tank Engine.
Right. I don't really think the Americans built war trains, as they were called.
Well, you know, the Americans didn't really get involved, to be honest, because, you know, they're just...
Yeah, well, that's...
Unusual.
That's what I mean. You could search for German war train, something like that. They made trains which were basically steel beasts with cannons, lots of anti-air stuff. Loads of stuff that you don't want to encounter when you're standing next to the tracks, to be honest. And it can kill you. A train can kill you anyway, but it can kill you in different ways now. Look, trains became creative. Alright, so I guess Timothy is googling it. Well, spoken about trains, Timothy, do you know if there's going to be a new train simulator? Because that's... I'm looking forward to quite some games, but that's the only game that I'm not sure of there's going to be a new version of.
I don't know. I was looking something up earlier, because I remembered Biffin linked me to something on on our Facebook group a while back. Literally like over a year ago, I think, at this point. May last year. It was... like a new version of Trains with a Z, like I was talking about earlier. Trains, a new era. I was just watching the trailer while you were discussing VR. It looks fairly competent. I mean, it seems pretty much like the same game as it was before, but with like some serious graphical improvements by the look of it.
All right. But did it also change other stuff?
I think it's got new physics engine and stuff. It looks a lot better than the cheapy ones that I've bought before by the same people.
Yeah, okay. It's
apparently made by Deep Silver. I thought they were the people that made also worked on the train simulator on Steam. Maybe I'm wrong on that one.
I kind of don't know, to be honest.
So I know Dovetail Games are the main developers of the Steam one, but...
Let's see... A to Z. And that, I don't see Train Simulator on their website. No, I don't see Train Simulator on their website, but they might have helped in it, yeah? I do remember the logo, seeing it, that one somewhere, so you never know.
Yeah.
There are going to be quite some games, or for example, new Call of Duty, Train Simulator, Farming Simulator. What are you guys looking forward to? That's not a lot.
Everything's coming out, to be honest.
I'm looking forward to a game, No Man's Sky, which is coming out only on the PS4, if I'm correct. That's an endless... I think it's like set in a... just in a single galaxy, but basically you just... There you go, start exploring, do whatever you want. But the planets are like... I think it is... whatever 8 is stands for, 8 trillion like stars in the system, and yeah, it can take you like a month just to reach one of your own friends that are playing the game because it's just so vast.
Really?
Yeah, no, wow. You're not, you can play with people, but you could be spawned in different locations and you may never ever see them in the game.
Oh, wow.
If you're friends with them, it will tell you where they are, but it's trying to encourage to bring back working with random people. Literally trying to force you to interact with other players instead of either going solo, you can go solo, or if you want to join up in an alliance with people, you can, but it'd be absolutely random people. They're trying to focus on that instead of literally just say a group of friends here and a group of friends here, and they don't interact with anyone ever. And it's trying to build another community. It's gonna suck at first because everyone's now used to just playing with their friends. But in the past, when you played games on massive online playing games, you played with your friends, but you also played with a lot of other people. Yeah. And you get to know them, and that was a good way to build up a small community as we got like now with LOSUMG. It's a little community getting together, we play games, but this is on a big scale. It's going to be interesting, but that's a game I'm looking forward to at the moment, so
yeah.
Which is August, I think, is coming out this year. It did get pushed back from July.
Oh, right. Well, it sounds cool. The only downside of random people is that they tend to be quite stupid.
Yes. Yeah, well, that's literally going to be the problem. So,
yes.
But we'll see how it all goes.
Yeah. So, we basically had anything that was on the list. Do you guys have anything else to talk about? To notice games you want to... games you are expecting, stuff like that.
Not that I can necessarily. I did see something on Twitter the other day. It's not a DLC that's been announced or anything yet, but it was like a small bit about one of the narrow gauge railways in Wales, which I don't think is open anymore. There's a section on Dovetail Game or the Train Simulator website about that, which I was quite excited about, because they've only recently added a narrow gauge route, and it was one set in America, so I wasn't particularly interested. But now, if they're going to release one set in Britain, that's going to be really fun for me, and probably something else I'm going to get annoyed at some point.
I'm looking forward to the stream.
Yeah.
I really am. Are you going to use the webcam then?
Yeah, I should think so, yeah.
Cool.
I need to get a bit of webcam, really, but it's all right for just streaming, I think.
Yeah. Oh, well. So, I guess that's going to be it for this month's podcast. Well, let us know what games are you looking forward to What are your opinions on stuff that's been released? For example, GTA update, maybe new train simulator content. Anything, just let us know. Well, that's gonna be it. I'm gonna say thank you very much for watching. We've been No Snow, Titmuff, you've been here, and Doc.
Hello, bye.
Goodbye. No Snow's muted, but goodbye from him as well. Goodbye, folks.
See you later, guys.